Welcome to the fourth episode of the Linux command line Ultimate Tutorial Series. In this video, you will learn what's the difference between hard and soft links and how to use them in your system. Let me first explain you the concept of hard and soft links. In Linux system, the information underneath your file system is stored in inode. This is how computer sees this information. But you actually see files in your system, and a file in your file system is just a link to this inode. So when you create a hard link, you create a link directly to the inode. And you may have many different hard links. Actually, when you have a file on your system, it is also a hard link to that inode. You can have as many hard links as you want, but if you remove all hard links, when there is no a hard link which is linked to this inode, this inode will be also removed. And here comes the major difference between hard and soft links. The hard link is linked to the inode, the hard link is linked to the information. But the soft link is linked to the file name, not to the information. So if you rename this file, the soft link will not work anymore, because it would be linked to the previous file name, which doesn't exist anymore. But it will not affect the hard link, because the hard link is linked to the inode, not to the file name. So even if you remove this file name, the inode will still exist and it will be linked with this hard link, so you will still have that file on your system. But if you remove all hard links, the inode will disappear. But it is safer for the soft link, because if you remove soft link, it will not affect your inode, so it will not affect the information which is stored on your system. So there are some other differences between hard and soft links. The major one is probably that hard links are limited to one file system. This means that you cannot create hard links between different partitions and between different hard drives. But you can create soft links between different partitions and between different hard drives. There are some other minor differences, but I think for a regular user, they should not matter. So let's demonstrate exactly how hard links and soft links work. I need to open the terminal. Then I press F11 to make it full screen, and I will change my working directory to public. So here we will create two files which we will use to make hard and soft link. Let's create one file which will have the word hard in it, and we will call it file1, and let's create another file with the content soft, and we will name it file2. So now, if you list the content of this directory, you can see we have two files here. And I hope you recall the previous episode where you learned how to view the content of files. We can type the command cat and the name of the file. So this is the content of file1, and this is the content of file2. Now let's create a hard link for the first file and a soft link for the second file. You need to type the command ln, which means to create a link. It's a short command from link. Name of the file for which you want to create a link, and the name of the link. And we will call it hard link. For the second file, we will create a soft link. Again, you type the command ln, but here you need to add the option s, which means to create a soft link. And by the way, soft link and symbolic link, it means the same, so you can use this name interchangeably. So you add option S to make a soft or symbolic link. Again, the name of the file for which you want to create a link, and the name of the link. So let's list the content again. Now we have our two files which we had before, and a hard link and a soft link. And you can already spot the difference. When you have a soft link, it shows you that it is linked to file2. So it is linked to the name of this file. So let's view the content of this hard and soft link. I will clean this screen with Ctrl L, and I will type the command cat to view the content of hard link. You see, it has the content hard, which basically is the same as file1. We can also view the content of the soft link. It has the content soft, which is the same of the file2. So now let's see what happens if we rename file1 and file2. So let's rename the file 1 to file1.1 and file 2 to file2.1. If we list the content, now you can see we don't have file 1 and file 2 anymore. We have file 1.1 and file 2.1. But the soft link is still linked to file 2. If we try to view the content of this file, as we have done here, we won't see any content. We will get this error, because file 2, the name of the file, doesn't exist anymore. The information of the file 2 is still exist, so the inode is linked to file 2.1 now, but the file name doesn't exist, that's why we cannot open it. But if you remember, the hard link is linked to the inode, and file 1.1 is also linked to the inode. So we renamed file 1, but it doesn't matter here because hard link is linked to inode, not to the file name. If we try to use the content of hard link, we can see that it works because we can see the content of the hard link is hard. So this is one of the major differences. Now let's clean this screen again, list the content. And the next what I want to demonstrate you is if you remove the previous link to the file, which is file 1.1, but you keep hard link, the inode will still exist. So this is the original file name. It was file 1 and we rename it to file 1.1. If we remove it, so now it doesn't exist anymore. But if you use the content of hard link, it still exists because the inode still has one link, so that information exists on your system. If you decide to remove this hard link, the inode will also be removed, so the information will disappear. But if you remove soft link, it will not matter. For example, let's create another soft link. You type ln with option S, and we create a soft link for file 2.2. And again, we name it soft link. Oh, it exists, so let's first remove the old soft link. And now we create soft link again. So I will clean the screen. So now the soft link is linked to file 2.1. If you view the content of this soft link, it will be the same as the content of file 2.1. You see, it's the same. If I remove this soft link, it will not matter because the soft link is linked to the file name. So I remove soft link, but the file 2.1 still exists. But if I remove file 2.1, I will remove the direct link to the inode. So even if I had this soft link, it would not work because inode will be removed. Soft link just linked to the file names. So let me demonstrate you the last feature of soft and hard links. If I go to my home directory and I go to my MNT directory where I have several hard drives which are mounted on this system. So these hard drives represent different file system from my main file system. And if I go here to my YouTube directory, for example, and I copy this path, then I navigate to my home directory and I want to create a soft link to this YouTube directory in my home directory. I type the command ln with option S. Then I paste the path to this YouTube directory. Let's make it full screen. And I also name it YouTube. Now, as you see, I have a link in my home directory to this mounted hard drive, which is Western Digital 750 GB, and I have a YouTube folder in that directory. If I go to my file manager, to my home, you can see here's a link we have just created, and it has this sign, which means it's a link, so it's a soft link. If I click on it, I will enter directly into my YouTube folder, which has quite a long path as you can see here. But I can make a shortcut on my home directory and enter that directory just with one click. So it is a soft link to that directory, which is very convenient. Also, if I remove this, it will not affect my YouTube directory. So I click delete, but I go back to MNT, my Western Digital hard drive, YouTube, it still exists. So this is very convenient. For example, if you have your home directory, but it is not very big, and you want to store more information in your home folder, you can just create many links to another hard drive and access that information from within your home directory. This can also be used to shorten the paths, because as you have seen here, this path is quite long, and it takes a lot of time to go through all these folders until you reach like YouTube folder. But when I create this link here, I can access it just with one single click. Well, I agree, these hard and soft links may be a little bit confusing. I think the concept of the hard link is especially difficult. So just don't worry about the hard links. Use soft links, they are much easier to understand and they are safer to use. Thank you for watching.